We want to argue that Europe needs to do better in countering anti-Muslim narratives.
Dominant Islamophobic narratives convey and reinforce the idea that there is an intrinsic incompatibility between the West, Europe, Portugal, and Islam.
So we focused on the extreme right, conservative and liberal voices. Liberal voices are certainly not the dominant narratives or generators of narratives of Islamophobia, but they're perhaps the most alarming ones.
There is a constant pressure on Muslims to show no signs of foreign culture and religion, and when they do, they are perceived as illegitimate and not fully French.
There is a need of mobilizing the expertise of Muslim individuals as resource for the wider society instead of pointing at them as the causes of these problematic issues.
Until today, Islamophobia is not recognized as a form of discrimination. So this is one of the most important tasks that needs to be conveyed in Germany.
At an EU level, it was this parliament that took the lead on the issue of Islamophobia. We had to drag the Commission, literally, screaming to a point to which they had no choice left but to recognize that there is a problem called Islamophobia. And it took years of tremendous hard work by so many good colleagues in this House. And I remember after about a good 4 years sitting in the chamber, and at that time it was Commissioner Vivian Reding, she actually came, took the floor, and she said, "Yes, today I am announcing that the European Union is going to officially recognize that we have a problem called Islamophobia, and we are going to start to design policy frameworks to deal with it." And I remember just sitting there thinking, finally. And so on the one hand, as a parliamentarian, I'm quite pleased to see the sorts of developments that are happening. But on the other hand, I equally recognize the tremendous challenges that are facing us. The political dialogue has clearly moved in the past decade or two. With that also, we see at an international level the dismantling of the international world order as a rules-based system. One block at a time, it is being dismantled. And we've got to recognize that today. And that is where we as politicians are grossly failing at this moment in time.
We have had now for 20 years a kind of, 20 years plus, an evolving regime of anti-terrorism laws, which effectively create at best, a sort of third-class citizenship for Muslims, but also there are measures within those laws themselves which can allow you to be literally stripped of your nationality if you have citizenship. And all the while, the reasons that these laws have been able to be introduced in a country that, you know, at least at some ways used to pride itself on the idea of equality, of this kind of vast idea of Britishness, which has a troubling link with its own colonial history, but nevertheless was there. This regime has been kind of turned on its head. This analysis, these discourses are no longer there.